I remember two Willie Binghams. One, pasty-faced with fear after the sentence was read, and the other, after the series of amputations. The first is now blurred by the painfully sharp focus of the second. I was the very first surgical supervisor appointed under the state's revised stance on capital crime. My job? To see that medical protocol was followed, that inmates would not suffer any more than the usual post-surgical discomforts.
You're going to remove my hand?
That's correct.
No way!
Well, you are a murderer, Mr. Bingham.
Oi! One! Oi! No, sir, that is not fair! I killed that girl, but that weren't me, alright? It was the booze. The drugs. Up. Something awful. They're saying I mutilated her. I never.
The first surgery is largely symbolic.
Symbolic?
Correct.
Well, piece of cake then. Nothing to worry about, huh?
Well, I'm here to make sure you suffer no more pain than is necessary.
Why don't you just do what they used to do, huh? Just execute me! Once and for all!
You ought to be made a national example of. Your chance for recompense. It's expected that the reduction should cease by the second or third surgery.
Please. Surviving family members determine how far the surgeries will go.
This is what my criminal ways got me. You best all mind yourselves, kids. Because you don't want this. No. You don't ever want this!
In March, they remove Mr. Bingham's right arm and his left leg.
Proceed.
You may proceed.
Don't hurt none.
Hmm.
Where's my supervisor?
As Mr. Bingham's procedure advanced, he was exhibited to the more difficult cases in the underfunded state-run high schools.
His hands.
Behave yourselves now. Unless you want to look like me.
Although Mr. Bingham was recovering well physically, his outlook grew progressively darker as the third surgery approached. Upstairs are very pleased with your progress, Willie. I don't expect the family will take it any further. Every job hits patches of rough road. There are times I strain to glimpse the bitumen below it all.
You may commence.
Mr. Bingham gave up a kidney and a lung. Organs from inmates provide a small but steady revenue stream for our now privatized penal system.
Nurse?
Yes, Mr. Bingham.
I ain't cutting off my right leg, or is that my left?
It's your left leg, Mr. Bingham.
Left leg?
Left leg.
Five months later, the fifth surgery was ordered.
Please don't do this.
No, no, Mr. Bingham. It will all be over soon.
Mr. Bingham, would lose his namesake. Willie. Willie. You okay? You're in pain, Willie.
Willie.
I never saw Mr. Bingham cry after that day, nor has he spoken to me since. He went into his final surgery without any observable emotion. They removed his ears, his nose, and the tip of his tongue. A laser depilated what remained of his body. We've made it through to the end now, Willie. That was 5 years ago. Mr. Bingham's room is the last on the southern end of the top floor. The light is always on. And I know he's there. Eyes to the ceiling. Dead silent. Except the last week of every month. That's when Mr. Bingham and I travel to the high schools.